With the best will in the world, the surge in boosting is not going to kick in for 3 or 4 weeks, but now is the moment when people are going to parties, they're going to the pub. Why aren't you more explicitly discouraging them from doing that? Dr. Gooding, you said that your colleagues are working incredibly hard. They're exhausted. For 18 months, they've been putting their lives at risk. If I could ask you and Professor Whitty, how did you and they feel when you saw those photos of officials in Downing Street and Conservative Central Office having parties when they were risking their lives and the rest of us were in lockdown? And finally, Prime Minister, would you welcome a police investigation of the parties that took place here?
Sorry, I'm going to ask the... Chris, you want to go first?
I mean, I don't have a huge amount to add to what I said previously, which is I do think people should prioritise what matters, and that by definition means deprioritise other things. And I think people are doing that, and I think I would recommend that, and I think most people would recommend that. I don't think you need a medical degree to realise that is a sensible thing to do with an incredibly infectious virus about which there are quite a lot of key things we don't know. And then in terms of other areas, I mean, yes, I mean, I think it's a statement of fact that when people think there's unfairness, and particularly if they think there's unfairness in high places, of course people get angry. I'm not commenting on individual cases or commenting on the rights or wrongs of anything, to be honest. I've never have throughout this, and I don't intend to start now. But what I do think is most people actually separate that out from their absolute need to think seriously about what's good for them, their communities, their families, their workplaces, and the wider country. And people, I think, really are taking that very seriously, and I don't think those two are in conflict. I think people basically can do both simultaneously.
I think what I would add is that our staff, as I said, have been working for a really long time, both through the pandemic and to deliver this incredible vaccination programme, and I think they'll keep going. You know, whatever else happens nationally in other places, we're here to look after our patients and our public, and that's what drives me every day, you know, no matter what else is going on, and that's what my teams and my colleagues will continue to focus on.
And I just say to you, Robert, that I think you completely mischaracterised the events in this place where people, to the best of my knowledge, have worked blindingly hard for a very long time in cooperation with people around government and across the whole of the public services to do our very best to keep people safe. But we'll, of course, hear from the Cabinet Secretary about what he believes has happened, and indeed, you know, if the police think there's anything to follow up, I'm sure that they will. But I think that, if I may say so, I think that the public can readily, as I think colleagues have said, the public can readily distinguish between these types of reports and these types of accounts and the overwhelming imperative that we have now together to tackle this disease in the two-pronged way that we are. And I think those are the messages that I'm seeing the public understand very, very loud and clear, and really responding magnificently with the way people are. You said it, you know, it'll take 2 or 3 weeks for the vaccine rollout to get going. That's not my impression.
It's the immunity to build up.
Well, I think that is a moot point, because I think that I'd like to hear from Nikki and Chris on that. I believe that with the booster, you start to get at least some immunity, perhaps a bit quicker than you've suggested, but perhaps that would be...
Well, I think the general point is a very reasonable one. Actually, the timing, yes, I would expect some protection, probably even beginning within a week, and quite a bit within two. So it's a bit quicker, but your general point, which is, of course, there's going to be a delay, is a fair one. It's just probably slightly less than you were implying. Nikki?
Yep. I mean, all we can do is move as fast as we can so we can get people protected. And that's why the other points that Chris and PM have already made are right. You know, we follow the guidance that's there. Work from home if you can. We need those trains as empty as possible so essential workers can go in safely. Wear your mask as much as you can, and look after each other. That's what we're here to do.
Thanks. Tom Newton, Dunn, The Times.
Professor Whitty, question for you.